Hello, people from around the world. Thank you for watching this video, and thank you for following my channel. Today I would like to present you and to share with you my experience of Honda nc750x after 2 years of owning and after 30,000 kilometers on the clock. So regarding this bike, I have only nice words. I would like to say this is the best bike in the world. This is not my first bike. First NC 700X I bought 2013. Then I bought GS 1200 2014, then NC750X model 2014 or 15, I'm not sure. And from 2016 I had 3 Africas, CRF 1000 manual, and 2 years ago I switched. Someone will say I drop in terms of performance to NC750X manual. I don't think so, that I drop quality of riding. By numbers, yes, it's dropped from 58 horsepower, from actually 95 horsepower, what was in Africa, or GS 125 horsepower to 58. It's big difference. But this is just numbers. I would like to share my experience that in terms of performance on the road, NC, in realistically, it's maybe 20% less performance. So with GS on highway, you can cruise easily 140, 150. With Africa, 140. With NC, I'm going easily 130, 140. And also the fuel consumption, it's really unbelievable. Yesterday I had one tour here in Serbia. I visited some of my friends across the country. So I moved around 570 kilometers. All mileage was on B road. And my fuel consumption with one tank on beginning, I covered 390 kilometers. Actually, I spend 13.1 liters, and the fuel consumption is below 3.5 liters. This is unbelievable. And on highway, when I keeping speed 130, 140, the fuel consumption cannot exceed 4.5 liters. Now we're talking about fuel consumption, but motorcycling, it's not meaning only fuel consumption and to care about these numbers, so it will be also enjoy. I would like to say that fully I'm enjoying this motorbike, and also for commuting it's much better than GS, where filtering is a bit problematic because of cylinders, or with Africa, where is riding position, it's much taller, and then you have to care when you're stopping. You have some rocks down on the road, and you have watched carefully. With this bike, I'm very stable and very secure reaching the ground, so the chance of sliding of my shoes are really to minimum. As well, I would like to say that this is an amazing touring machine. Till now, actually in past 2 years with this bike, I did 10-11 times for sure, more than 1,000 kilometers in one day. My longest trip was last July. I go from Belgrade to Rome to Italy with motorbike. So in 14 hours of riding, I covered 1,000 310 kilometers. Total was 18 hours, so I had a few stops. My first stop was after 250 kilometers to get fuel, and then I stopped in Zagreb to get some sweet, and then my next stop was in Rijeka in Cantrida Beach. I spent around 1 hour, and next my trip was in Italy on petrol station, and next one was in Bologna, so I get dinner there, and next one was close to Roma, and then finally I reach Roma. So total 18 hours, 14 hours and 10 minutes of riding without stopping. Was extremely hot, was 37-38 in Croatia. On my way from Zagreb to Rijeka, I had a situation on the road that asphalt melting, and then I goes to old road from Zagreb to Rijeka to B roads. It was amazing and not so busy and with so much shade of trees, so it was without any problem. 1300 kilometers. I was very scared of engine performance on superheat, of overheating, of problem with the liquids or something, but thank God there was everything exceptionally excellent. 1000 kilometers many times from here to Montenegro, to Croatia, and then example back to Sarajevo. Really, I would like to say this is fantastic. This is fantastic touring machine, and it's much easier to ride on highway than GS because it's a bit lower position. So it's 13 centimeters if you compare GS. I'm not sure, GS 1200 was 18 or 20 centimeters far from ground, and Africa Twin around 22-25, so much easier. And also the vibration are not crazy, so you can easily do very much mileage. I didn't change factory seats. I don't know why so many people complaining about seat. So I have a regular seat. I just make better foot pegs. I put Aro, I like so much. Here is Hepco and Becker crash protection with GV fog lights, fork protectors, factory hand guards, and factory touring windshield with GV adapters. So really, this is amazing to ride. Here I put in Garmin. Here is for my phone. So look the mileage, 30,799 kilometers in 2 years and 10 days. So I bought beginning of July 2021. Also I put heated grips, original from Honda, and I have Givi top case and rack. And also I put, it's very useful, this is my website, and also I put this mud guard. It's amazing and really protecting the rear suspension a lot. So it's a really amazing bike. For city, it's like scooter. You go easily, you're spending less petrol than with scooter. And what is the main advantages of this motorbike and reason why I bought so many times NC? I like Africa, to be honest. I like GS because I'm guessing that this is the best engine in the world. Honda and NC, it's my new concept. I remember very well before I bought NC 700X 2013 that on Honda website, especially on Honda American website, I think Honda Power Sport or something like this, was very clearly mentioned that this is a revolution in motorcycling, that Honda engineers cut it half of engine of Honda Jazz, and they put into the bike. So that's why it was NC, like new concept. I remember it very well, but this information you can find on just on some reviews, but officially cannot find that. I don't know what is the reason. Maybe Honda is shame, or they respect another factories and they are hiding this data. But this engine 750, it's half of the engine of 1.5 liter Honda Jazz. And I remembering also, because on that time I had a Honda Jazz, the same engine, 1.5 petrol. This engine is awarded 2010 in USA as a best petrol engine. And very interesting that still Honda using today this engine in their car, example with Honda Civic, just turbo is added, or Honda CR-V, and even in Honda hybrid cars, the hybrid system are connected with this 1.5 petrol, so probably the best engine, and one of the reason why this bike it's not expensive, almost three times cheaper than GS. Its engine is very cheap. Actually, they using engine from the cars and they just putting into the bike. And difference with this bike with previous generation is that you can easily rev it on 4,500, 4,700 RPM. The bike becoming very very lively, and really it's pleasure to ride. I talked with some guys, they using on 2,500 RPM, and they say there is no performance. But really, I don't know how can be performance if you're keeping some engine on 2,500 RPM. This is crap. The first generation of NC on 3,500, you feel very uncomfortable. Many times I ask a question, what's going on with this engine, because the vibration was crazy. And on this model, I feeling vibration only after 6,000. Probably someone will ask why I don't have a top case. I removing. I only put in when it's necessary, because I using a lot this storage. Someone say Frank, it's very useful. Also there I keeping chain, I keeping gloves, I keeping first aid, I keeping tools. Really amazing bike. I love so much NC, and I say to everyone, even when I go to visit my friends in Honda service center and showroom here in Belgrade, by the way, nice guys. Sometimes they ask me when you will buy again Africa or NT1100. I say I thinking about that really, but I know when I buy again Africa or NT, I will again cry for NC. So I did this a few times, and I say I got lesson. So that's why I would not looking to sell this bike. Maybe to buy additional Africa, is it okay? But to sell NC and to buy another bike, no thanks. Only if I must. I hope that I will not be in this case. Regarding off-road, as you can see, my rear wheel. Yesterday I had a short one when I go to my friend on gravel. It's amazing, really. It was very, very steep downhill, and then way back uphill without any issue, just traction control. What I don't like with this bike when I'm off-road, I cannot switch off traction. So I cannot switch off traction, and as well I would like to switch off rear ABS. So unfortunately, when you're keeping off-road, you feel how computer works, and it's cutting you a bit. Also, the front suspension is improved a lot if you compare with previous generation, and the rear suspension is crap. On my previous NC, I fixed that. I bought Ohlins suspension, and really it's changed the bike a lot. Now, if I want to do the same with this bike, Ohlins requesting 1,000 euros, so it's not cheap. But you have the knob that you can set up easily preload, and I think also they have preload or something, I'm not sure, rebound or dumping. So it's it will cost me 1,000 euros, so I'm thinking about that, but generally it's okay, I cannot complain because this is downside, rear suspension. Positive side, I would like to say reliability, and then quality, and then for me very important, made in Japan. I'm not racist, but I'm guessing that bike from Japan are much more better in terms of quality than Hondas coming from Spain or from Italy or from Thailand, I don't know from where. So quality, and then easy to ride, very much easy to ride, even for short distance, for long distance, the bike, it's really behaving like a dream. It's not for the passenger. This is difference between this bike and example bigger bikes. So I can compare exactly with GS and with Africa. So if you are alone, you don't feel much difference between NC and other bikes. But if you have Pillion, so you will feel lack of power. But even with my wife on highway, we're going 130, 140, I would like to say easily, just on uphills, I need to put in fifth gear, cannot keep in six, and fuel consumption is a bit bigger. And on the Pillion, you will feel crap of rear suspension. So I'm avoiding to ride with my wife, because it's not, not necessary, and in terms of safety. So generally I'm very much impressed with this bike, and I hope that this video will help with someone who thinking about Honda or something else or something bigger, and also for this price you're getting half of the price, almost half of the price of Africa, or one third of new GS. And you're really getting a lot. You're worry free. One also very interesting thing, that still I have factory parts. So you can see it's very thin. I have to change. I order. So maybe I have few 100 kilometers left to change. 30,000 kilometers in one disc. And the rear one are almost like a new. So I would like just to say one word, Honda. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and all comments and questions are most welcome. Warm regards to all of you from Belgrade, from Serbia. Stay safe and have a nice season. Thank you guys. Ciao.